Hey guys, welcome back. So in my previous video, we understood how to store the patient data, how to process appointment reminders, and now we are going to focus on how to send bulk emails to the customer for increasing the social engagement. Let's start and open our studio. Let's develop our new blank task. Let's call it bulk messaging. Send bulk messages to the clients. All right, so the first thing I'm going to do is configure my notebook file. And what I'm going to do is that I'm going to refer to the config file that we had created for our appointment process, right? And I'm also going to point to the same input file that we have. All right. So let's quickly glance at what I have created in my config file. Okay. So what I have done here is I have created a space to enter the body of the message, of the email message. Now this can be configured as and when and how the user likes it. The address remains the same, the subject remains the same, and signature remains the same. Now these all can be configured by the client. All right, so let me close this one for now. Let's save this. All right, now what I'm going to do is that again, our main source is Excel file. So let's first start pointing at Excel. Let's go to today's appointment and customer data because that's our common input file. Uncheck the create if doesn't exist. Okay. Here, what we are going to do is that we need to send messages to all our customer and all our email addresses are in our customer data. Let's take a look at the customer data that we have. So now when you notice that the name Kalyani is repeated once, and if the person comes into picture again, I will be creating an entry for Kalyani and I'll be adding the necessary details. That means that the email addresses can be repeated. So what we need to do is that from this sheet, we need to fetch email addresses only that are unique. So if I was a normal person, what I would have done is that I would have selected on this email ID, I would have gone to data, remove the duplicates and just fetch the details of unique email addresses, right? Now that's exactly what we need to do using UiPath Studio, but how, right? So let's see if there is something for duplicates. Yes, I can see remove duplicates. All right. Again, we have said save changes. In this scenario, we don't need to save the change because we are removing duplicates only for our reference. We do not want any changes in our Excel file. Does our Excel file have headers? Yes, it does. The range, we are going to again stick to appointment card. Now, which column I have to remove the duplicates from. So our reference is going to be email IDs. All right. Then once the duplicates are removed, we need to send an email for every row that are filtered. Okay. So in our scenario, again, for each Excel row, what we are going to do is in the range, again, appointment has headers. Yes. Save after each row. No. And SMTP because we need to send the email. Okay, so true in this scenario is going to be current row and the email IDs that we found, right? Subject is going to be the notebook that we had configured, and subject is this one. I'm going to save it, close the file, and here the body is again in my Excel file, so that's the body. Let me just quickly confirm. Yes, B4, B2, and we are done. So let's close our Excel files. Again, there's an error. So let's take a look at how to configure the SMTP mail. So the port number that we need to add is 465. Server is smtp.email.com. Okay, let's add the email address. This is the ID from which you are going to send the emails. Okay, and the password is the 16-digit password. And how to fetch that password and how to enable the Google security system, I had shown it in previous video. If you are new, please scroll back and you can check it in my video. Okay, and here we go. Let's look at our email. It's empty. And now let's run the automation. Okay, let's scroll back. And yep, we have received our emails. I see that we do not get our signature. So let's quickly check what happened here. Text. Okay, so body is what I've added. I also need to add indicate in Excel and my signature here. Yep, now we are good. One thing that I have noticed is when we remove duplicates, sometimes a blank row can also be a duplicate, right? So to ensure that the row or the email address is not blank, let's put if condition. Check if the current row's email address is not empty, only then send out an email. So this is to ensure that if there are any blank rows encountered, we can directly ignore them and then send the email. So let's just add this activity here and let's run. Okay, and as you can see, it's become 20 minutes ago. We have received our email. All right, perfect. Now it's getting executed in 8 seconds. So this is the best optimization we can do. But there's another way that we can still optimize this code. And I'll wait for you to reply that in our comments. Give it a shot and suggest what's an easier way to optimize this code. Thank you for watching the video. If you have any queries or recommendations, please post them into the comment section.